Hi everyone, I'm here with Bill Lang, who heads up Small Business Australia, an organisation that is out there battling away supporting small business. Bill's been an ambassador for small business and working with them for some 30 years, including establishing Dr. Dog. Bill, g'day, how are you?
Yeah, hi David.
Tell us about Dr. Dog firstly.
Yeah, well, I grew up in Sebastopol on the south side of Ballarat and was fortunate as a 17-year-old to get into this place called Melbourne Uni and come down and live with a bunch of other, you know, mainly people that live from country Victoria at Newman College at Melbourne Uni. And we're a couple of years into our commerce degrees and we thought, well, geez, you know, it's pretty hard to get something to eat around closing time around pubs. And that's where we came up with the idea of Dr. Dog. So we started off with a pop-up caravan out the front of pubs at closing time. Ended up with a fleet of vans. I think these days in 2020, they call it the food trucks and the street food industry. But back then it was just three of us uni students driving around the Dr. Dog trucks, selling a few hot dogs to the late night revelers of Melbourne.
Fantastic. And things have moved on since then. And I know that you do a lot of work. We've crossed paths over a number of times of you supporting small businesses. So how did Small Business Australia get set up?
Yeah, look, years ago, I was fortunate to be doing my MBA over at Harvard, and it was in the late 80s, early 90s, and I helped a successful business person called Peter Boyle get something called the Australian Small Business Association together. Yep. And we arrayed thousands and thousands of small business owners who all paid some dollars for a newsletter in those days, but literally in the end ended up holding protests in the centre of Melbourne to do something about the destruction to the Victorian economy back then. And then since those days, I've been involved in a number of different businesses in a number of different countries. And several years ago, a bunch of small business owners, you know, were chatting with me saying, look, yeah, we've lost a voice. We need practical stuff going forward. And so we all got together. We said, let's create something that would actually help improve things for small business owners. So Small Business Australia has been conceived, designed and operated by small business owners for small business owners. It doesn't rely upon any form of government funding from any level of government. We do fact-based research. At the most fundamental level, we believe we'll have a better country if everything could be made just a bit simpler and a little bit fairer, and that will make things a lot better. And there's a lot of things we've seen in the last 6 months that are too complicated, very, very unfair. And we wouldn't say they're any way better, like they're much worse than what they needed to be. So we're very active at the moment, working with lots of small business owners, doing the research, prosecuting the case, looking to influence people to come on board and you know, support and save the small business sector. Because at the end of the day, there's 5 million Australians last Christmas depended on their financial security on operating their own or working in a small business. That's 5 million people.
Yeah.
And we often hear, David, many politicians talk about small businesses, the economic backbone of the country. We say, look, it's more than that. You know, that small business people are the hearts and souls of their local communities. They're the people sponsoring, you know, the local footy club, providing work experience for the school kids. So we're very focused, in the last several months doing everything we can to maximise the survival rate of these hearts and souls of our local communities.
So let's get to the heart of this, because one of the biggest issues that I've certainly been banging on for a while now is Daniel Andrews' laws have not been consistent. The rules are not certainly something that which you could apply right across the board. You see, just up the road from us in Caulfield Park, up to four or five gardeners sitting on leaning up against a shovel, standing around and digging a hole, whereas the local lawnmower person is not able to work. They're sitting at home, no JobKeeper, no support packages. You've got union workforces in warehousing and construction. They're out and about. Many of the small business and solo operators, they're not there. We've got a dog groomers just up the road. They're not able to open. They just established that business and they're sitting at home with no income. So you must be hearing that kind of stuff all the time.
Well, look, let's just go back to the sort of the themes at Small Business Australia. Simpler, fairer, better. So we take Victoria, for example, 600,000 small business entities we had at Christmas time. Of those, 350,000 are self-employing small business people, tradies, barbers, hairdressers, people running their own little lawn mowing business. They don't employ anybody. Well, you know, the very first thing is they're not eligible for any substantive financial assistance from the Victorian government. So they've got $350,000, they're not getting anything. Then you look at things like JobKeeper and JobSeeker. It's not just a state government related issue here. So complicated. You know, where's the small business saver package? That's what we really need, something that's simple and fair so that we can be all in this together, because I can tell you at the moment, there's, I think, 1.3 million people depend upon small businesses in Victoria to be operating so that they have jobs or that they're self-employed. And at the moment, they've been hung out to dry in many respects, particularly, you know, the lifters, the people that run their own business, that get up, that take the risks, that live in the private risk economy. And one thing I will say we're pleased is we had Gary Morgan ask a question for us in the last 24 hours around what Victorians think about the extent to which, you know, the government should be reimbursing and ensuring that small businesses do survive. And 76% of Victorians responded, absolutely. Small businesses that have had to close down temporarily or permanently as a result of government responses to COVID-19 should be compensated. We're definitely not in all this, not in this together, one iota.
So Bill, 26th of October, another deadline, let's call it. We're all in lockdown essentially to then. There's no certainty whether those businesses are going to be open after that. What needs to happen now? So what does Daniel Andrews need to do tomorrow that could be safe in terms of a COVID environment, but get businesses back to work and ensure those jobs survive and those businesses survive and thrive?
Look, let's remember that at the end of the day, you know, small business people and those businesses, we work for customers, meeting customer needs. Customers are the oxygen of every business and of every small business. When the oxygen is cut off because they're not allowed to come and see you, or you're not allowed to be open, or they're that frightened and that fearful about this thing called COVID that's everywhere and it's invisible and it's like a bushfire. It's not like a bushfire whatsoever. There are small little outbreaks here and there. Now, I still remember how bad it was Black Saturday, but I tell you what, Black Sunday was last week, David, in terms of the implications for these businesses. So it's pretty simple. Let us start getting opened up and let's start promoting keeping well as opposed to staying safe. Consumer confidence has been sapped. People have been, you know, scared out of their wits for no good reason. Now, we're doing some research at the moment around what is the true number of ventilators here in Victoria? How many tens of thousands of positive cases can the Victorian health system actually manage? And it's much, much more than what's taking place at the moment. But then it's just these nonsensical things which people know. Why wear a mask when I'm out walking the dog and there are no people anywhere near me? There's only sort of three things, and, you know, at the end of the day, that the consumers need to do. And we've got it all as part of our sort of, you know, keep well, buy local campaign. But, you know, two hands, keep them clean. Mm. You know, two arms, keep two arms apart distance. And then for everyone, buying local, and particularly state and local governments dealing with local businesses. I think the big thing we want to hear beyond sort of being able to open back up in a safe way, in a way where everyone is keeping well, is what's the compensation that's going to be paid for the businesses that have already had to close permanently as a result of this, or are very close to having to do it. Another big state government area is the relationship between commercial landlords and commercial tenants. And the current, you know, sort of machinery of government, the bureaucracy, VCAT, all of those sorts of things, they're not going to work. You know, there's going to be tens and tens of thousands. Let's start using some smart technology, pro forma approach to come up with a fair result so that everyone takes, from a finance point of view, a bit of a haircut with respect to the debts that are owed, as opposed to it all being lumped on the small business owner who's going to end up decapitated.
So I know, Bill, there are a lot of people that will be listening out there today that will say they're frustrated. They have, you know, this premier and this government around for still potentially two years to come. What can people do now to air their frustration? What can they actually do to build a campaign to ensure their voices are heard?
Look, at Small Business Australia, we've just finalised something we're calling Save Our Small Businesses. And the website address is sosbiz.com.au. So SOS, Save Our Small Biz, biz.com.au. And what people will find there is basically 10 steps that we're asking ScoMo and Co in Canberra, down to the premiers of every state and territory, and down to the mayors and the CEOs and councils of every local government. There are 10 really straightforward, eminently doable things that will keep more small businesses alive and have them geared up and ready for thriving. And we're asking everyone, you don't need to be a small business owner to come and sign this petition. If you're a customer, if you believe small businesses are the heart and soul of your local community, come and sign this petition. Get other people to sign the petition. We're then gearing up. That petition will then start landing both at local government level, particularly here in Victoria. The council elections are happening next month, at state government level and at the federal level. We will not give up. And the more people that are with us, that are truly in it together with saving our small businesses, the better chances we've got of getting some more sensible things implemented much faster and saving more small businesses.
Bill, thank you so much. Keep up the good fight, an important fight that needs to be won to ensure that our businesses are saved. To everybody out there, stay well, as Bill says, shop local, which is so crucial right now. And importantly, keep up the strength, the courage to ensure that we get this great state, Victoria, that we all love so much, back to where it needs to be. Thank you, Bill, for talking with me, and best of luck in your great endeavours in the future.
Thanks very much, David.